Hello, this is Charlie Zorro, and welcome to the second episode in the Adventures of Denesha. In this episode, we're going to go ahead and complete the intro. So at this point, we need to go talk to Dwarlin and tell him of Grummer's plans for the ritual. So we're going to go ahead and head out. Oh, and we just got mail. Let's see what this is. Oh, reduced awareness. So, find it interesting if there's reduced awareness in the intro, but, you know, apparently there is. Here we are.
Thank goodness you're here.
I bid you welcome, and I am at your service. Okay. Oh no, all of my dwarves are ill since coming here. That is more pressing than Grummer's folly.
Look! All of these dwarves are sick! Dying!
I cannot do another thing until I figure out what we can do to help them. I don't even know what happened to make them ill. How can we hope to cure them if we don't know how they came by this plague? Well, that's one thing we're going to do, is we need to go and take a look. Oh, and she has a title. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and keep her title for right now, Denesha of Lindon. Oh. What does Unar have to say?
Have you seen the Barohans nearby? Why do Bargus now haunt our fair lands?
Oh, well, we can't have that. We're going to go hunt some Bargas. We'll do that before we go and take a look to see why the dwarves are ill. Because the Bargas are right over here. And let's just make a circle. Oh, I just realized we only need to kill four, so let's go ahead and run back.
Ooh, those dogs chill my heart.
Okay. Now, let's go take some soil samples by the river, and we also want to take some samples of some sick bears. And here we are. Okay, let's take the soil samples. And I know it says sludge, but I always think that in some cases, especially the smaller piles, kind of remind me of pooh. And I don't mean the bear. Like this. Ugh. Since these poor bears are almost dead anyway, killing them is kind of a mercy. At least that's the way my characters would look at it. By the way, let you know, I do roleplay my characters. I'm not into heavy roleplay. thing because I don't know all of the Tolkien lore, or, you know, as you've already discovered, I have troubles pronouncing some of the names. So, but I do like to think of my characters as individuals, and they have their own goals and aspirations. And usually, as with any those goals will change over time. Okay, now we want to go back and talk to Dwalin. So I'm sure the same is going to happen with Denesha. I'm not exactly sure at this point exactly what her goals are going to be, other than to explore as much as possible. She is from Dulinan instead of Celadon, or Celandim, which is a for those of you not familiar with the area, in the southeastern tip of Ered Luin is where the elven villages are, and the main village is Celandim, and above that
is... If the water of the river has been tainted, that explains it.
Yes, it has been tainted, so...
Mountain springs should be the purest of water.
All right. Let's put on that ring real quick. And we want to go and... We want to go up the mountain path and defeat guards and find the source of the poison. So we'll go ahead and we'll do that. But anyway, Dulinan is the settlement just to the north of Celandim. And that is where Denesha's from. It's from Dulinan. And because of that, she is perfectly aware of hobbits. She's interacted with the hobbits of Needlehole. And so that's the way we'll be going into the Shire eventually, is through Needlehole and helping the dwarves over there. And who knows, might actually even become a bounder. I am playing on a VIP account, for those of you who might be wondering. Let's take this guy out first. Come back here, you coward. Yeah. And, anyway, I've been VIP since, I guess, after my first couple of weeks playing, when I decided I really enjoyed this. Come on, die. Die, die, die. Thank you. One of the main advantages of being VIP is that you do get free access to most of the areas, unless the area is an expansion, such as Moria or Mirkwood, any of those. It doesn't cost you anything to be able to get the quests, whereas with a free-to-play or a premium account, you do have to pay for it. Now, it's not grossly expensive, but it does add up after a while. And, now let's go ahead and talk to Elrond's other son. Okay, the dwarves with Dwarlin drank from the river water below, you say. That is ill tidings. The creatures here are transformed by plague and the look as if they will die very soon.
I believe there may be hope for the sick dwarves yet.
Okay, so we want to go into the Mirkstone tunnels and pick some of the healing herbs. And in the meantime, we want to put on the other ring. There we go. Ta-da! So anyway, there are definite advantages of being VIP. One of the ones that I really like that they didn't have when I first started is that you can get mail at any time. You don't have to go to a mailbox. And that comes in handy. Now, naturally, you have to go to a mailbox to send mail, but it's really nice to not have to bother with a mailbox all the time. Also, you get all your virtue and stat slots for free, where you have to pay them with a free-to-play or a premium account. I can't click on that. There we go. And also, by being VIP, you do help support the game. So, not that the free-to-play or premiums don't, but you get a little bit... I feel like I'm supporting the game a little bit more than if I were just premium. Yay, made level! That said, I do have several free-to-play accounts, primarily for housing alts, but I actually started playing one recently that was a housing alt and enjoyed it so much I just continued playing it. So I'm looking forward to actually seeing how a premium player advances in the game. And let's see, I want to change this a little bit. Okay, let's go back down, and what's this? Oh, cool, specializations. This is neat. This was introduced in the Helm's Deep expansion, and while a lot of players hate it, and I have to admit it took me a while to get used to it, I kind of enjoy it. So let's go ahead. Now I'm going to take a second. What I want to do is divvy up my attacks by ranged, by area effect and single. So if you take a look here, Swift Strike is a melee skill, but it's showing that it's against one opponent, as is Wild Attacks, and as is Savage Strikes. But if you take a look at Rend, it shows that there's a radius and a maximum number of targets. So these are your area attacks. So right now, she could attack up to five opponents that's attacking her and do it as an area attack, which is very, very cool. Also, the area attacks tend to do more damage. Unfortunately, with this being the intro, you can't really pull the creatures easily. So one of the advantages of the champion is you can actually... Oops, step aside. You can actually grab a bunch of characters and have them, or a bunch of monsters and have them chase you, and then use the area attack to take them out, which is really, really cool. Once we get out of the intro, I'll show you that. Okay, this is the last of the herbs. Oop, gotta take out the corrupt spirit. Okay, now we need to examine the cave for what might be causing the blight in Arid Luin. Well, I have a funny feeling that these spirits might have something to do with that. Yep, can't get any further. There's a field around that, but that's kind of cool too. Ooh, something is glowing green. That's a bad sign. Ugh. A mossy shrine. And an evil spirit. You cannot defeat us. Well, yeah, when you make yourself where you're not selectable. And he left. I will stand on the evil Lamassi shrine.
Whee!
Okay, enough of that. Oh, cool. Let's see if we can pull him. Come on, follow me. Hey, you. All right. Now let's see if we can do this. Ah, never could get the fervor up to be able to do the blade storm, but that's pretty cool. One thing to make note of, with the champion, you can go through and I forget exactly the term, I apologize, but it's like a dual strike. So now we get the blade storm. Basically, you can use both weapons, where with many characters, the second weapon, while it's useful, you really can't do much with it, but this you can actually use as a dual blade. It's really, really cool. Ah, there he is.
Ah, you will be a hero to those dwarves. These leaves can be crushed to make a powerful remedy.
Cool. We'll take the leaves back and help the dwarves. First, I want to put on my helmet. Let's see what this is. Ooh, two fate. Well, that's definitely better armor than I have. Oh, but that helm has to go. Okay. Let's run back. Oops. Helps if I select him. I just can't get over that slide as you put your weapons away maneuver. See? That is just the weirdest thing. Well, that's not a bad looking set of armor. She may actually keep that. Whoops. I'm holding down the W key as I'm using my mouse, so that's why she's kind of running off of things. Yeah, I actually kind of like that. All right, let's... Well, went too far.
Can this be?
Okay, let's administer the medicine and see what happens. Good. Now, one thing that Carol pointed out that's kind of neat, this is Matthew Stouthand. Once we get to Gundaman, he's the one that's in charge of Gondamon, which is really, really cool.
Dead is dead, in my opinion. What is this nonsense?
I always have troubles picking the color.
Come and stay a moment.
Okay. We're going to go ahead and select this. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to journey into Skorgrim's tomb along with the Sons of Elrond. And we're going to, let's see here, we will make a great stand against the Dourhands, and they will think twice before falling to greed again. So we'll go ahead and accept that, but I'm not going to start it just yet, because normally I skip this adventure or this quest, but you might enjoy seeing it. In essence, it's called Signs and Portents, and it says, you have had a long day and more dangers await. You should take some rest. There's a bedroll just over there you can use. I will wake you if anything happens. So we're going to go ahead and accept that and then click on the bedroll and travel now. And now we just want to sit back and enjoy the show.
Listen to my words. You know me, and I know you. You are one of my kin. One day, we will take the ships into the west, but it is not yet time. I will not long disturb your sleep. I can visit you in dreams for only a short time. I have looked into my mirror and seen much that worries me. Let me show you.
What they're showing is some of the areas that we can eventually adventure in. It's very, very cool. We'll definitely be going into Agmar. It's one of my favorite areas. As is Moria.
You are near to wakefulness. The last tendrils of sleep will soon release you. You ask why I wanted to show you this? It is for one reason. I saw you in my mirror, not once or twice, but often. Whether you desire it or not, your fate is tied to that of Middle-earth. Do not forget my words when you awaken. The free peoples of Middle-earth will have need of you. You must not fail them.
Well, that's pretty cool. I really like it because it does give you an overview of some of the areas that you can go into. Okay. Now, before we leave the intro, and I realize this is probably running a little long. First off, I love this dwarf that's so frustrated with building the statues. It's so cool. But there's one place I want to show you. If you took a look at at my video series of creating a housing alt, you saw it there. But just in case you didn't, I think it's kind of important. This is the Silver Deep guardhouse. You can only get here during the intro. They've got it locked out so that the door won't open during the normal game, which is a real shame because I think that this would be a wonderful place to come to roleplay. I mean, this is just gorgeous. And from what I've read, there used to be a quest associated with this, and during some release, I don't know which one, they canceled the quest. And now, because of that, they've closed the area. So, that's why the only time you can get in here is during the intro. Which is, again, kind of a shame. But I wanted to show it to you, because I think it's gorgeous. I would love if they would just open it up so we can get into it. But, I tell you what, let's go ahead and wrap up the intro. So, we'll run over here and see what we can do. Whee! Okay. So now, by the way, when you get ready to go into Skorgrim's tomb, you have to complete all the intro quests or they go away. So the one we just did with Galadriel, you have to do before you do this one, or you can't do it.
It would seem that Gormr and the Dourhands have allied themselves with evil fell spirits of old, just as Skorgrim himself did long ago. Now Ivar the Bloodhand, a gaunt lord, threatens to sway the Dourhands to evil with the terrifying ritual about to take place in Skorgrim's tomb.
Well, that sounds ominous, so...
There's evil in the air here.
We shouldn't delay too long, or we may miss our chance to stop whatever evil is happening here. All right, let's go. There. Okay.
Ivar is too powerful.
Okay, we may be too late, but Ivar is too powerful for us to storm the tomb directly. He will stop us if we try. We will need to find another way around. Okay. Well, we're going to follow Dwalin. See if he can find a way for us to be able to sneak up on him and stop him. Oh, that is just really cool. Oh no, it's too late. The ritual has begun. Gonna try to get a good angle, because this is kind of cool. In fact, let's see if I can run down here before they knock us out. Okay. Alright. I love how the skeletons just drop one by one as the spirits are sucked out of them. Head out. Let's go back this way. Now, if you're a hunter and you're quick enough, you can actually help take out the skeletons, but not much of a chance of being able to do it now. Let's not stand on the dwarf. Go for it. Smack it. Do it. Do it. All right. Okay, the Sons of Auron are going to stay behind to help protect the door. Well, actually to help protect, I guess, anyone doing this. Seriously? Oh, that doesn't look good. I saw some evil spirits up ahead. Leave my dwarven friends alone. Come here, you. Oh no, that poor dwarf just got squished. Yep, definitely time to get out of here. Come here, boys. Oh, Excellent. And she made level. Cool. Okay, so she'll be leaving the intro at 7th level. That's not too bad. It's about where I like her. This is very cool. But don't want to dawdle. This would be another area that would be nice if they could open it up so we could adventure in it. You do get to come back for a quest at 65th level, but even then, after the quest is over, you you can't come back in, which kind of sucks.
Let us leave these halls behind us.
Okay, and we're dropped off in Selendim, which is the elven village in Arid Luin. Oh, that's very pretty. Okay, let's go ahead and wrap this up.
Megovanen. Megovanen,
and we'll go ahead and
a moment of your time
and take her quest. So we need to talk to Cardeva. Excellent. And so this is where we're going to end the video for today. So when we come back, we'll go ahead and start the quests that are here in Arid Luin. So I certainly hope that you enjoyed the video. I had a lot of fun. I love the intro. And I also enjoy the quest that we're about to do now. So if you did enjoy the video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And until next time, safe journeys and take care.